USA Radio News with Robin Walensky.
No, I'm not going to be watching.
President Trump at the White House asked by reporters if he will be watching Robert Mueller's testimony on Capitol Hill Wednesday.
Probably. Maybe I'll see a little bit of it. I'm not going to be watching Mueller because you can't take all those bites out of the apple. We had no collusion, no obstruction. We had no nothing. We had a total no collusion finding.
And the president goes on to tell reporters,
the Democrats were devastated by it. They went crazy. They've gone off the deep end. They're not doing anything. They're not doing health care. They're not doing infrastructure. They're not lowering drug prices. I'm lowering drug prices. First time in 53 years that drug prices went down last year. 53 years.
And taking a look now at Wall Street, the Dow gaining almost 18 points to close at 27,171. The NASDAQ gaining 57 points. The S&P 500 up 8 points. You're listening to USA Radio News. Another former White House staffer landing a job with Fox News, USA Radio's Chris Barnes reports now from Washington, D.C.
It's the latest turn of the revolving door between the Trump administration and the president's favorite TV news network, Fox News. Raj Shah, who was formerly the White House principal deputy press chief, has now taken a new job at Fox Corporation as senior vice president. Shah joins former Trump aide Hope Hicks in the executive suite of this corporation, which formed earlier this year after Disney's acquisition of 21st Century Fox. For USA Radio News, I'm Chris Barnes.
In San Juan, Puerto Rico, tens of thousands of people holding the Puerto Rican flag continue to protest in the streets. They want Democratic Governor Ricardo Rosello to resign. They do not think he's doing a good job. Rosello says he won't be running again in 2020, but he's refusing to leave his post. This is USA Radio News. We've all heard of sick days, now the state of Oregon allowing students to take mental health days. USA Radio's John Hunt explains.
A new law in Oregon allows students to take mental health days now, just as they would sick days. The teams behind the bill say it's meant to respond to a mental health crisis throughout all schools. Governor Kate Brown signed the measure into law. The Oregon Health Authority reports suicide as the second leading cause of death among those in the state ages 10 to 34. Nearly 17% of 8th graders say they've considered taking their own life within the last 12 months. Haley Hardcastle is an 18-year-old from suburban Sherwood who introduced the bill along with other student leaders. She says it changes the stigma around mental health and encourages kids to be honest with their parents if they're struggling.
Taking a look now at Wall Street, the Dow gaining almost 18 points to close at 27,171. The NASDAQ gaining 57 points. The S&P 500 up 8 points. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo with an announcement about a Chinese company doing business with Iran. USA Radio's Tim Berg with the story.
Pompeo is attending the annual VFW convention in Orlando, Florida. Pompeo announced that the U.S. will be imposing sanctions on a Chinese oil trader company for accepting Iranian oil.
We said all along that any sanction will indeed be enforced. We can't tolerate more money going to the Ayatollah, putting American soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines, and putting their life at risk.
The sanctions are imposed as tensions remain high between the United States and Iran.
For USA Radio News, I'm Robin Walensky.